Hello everyone, welcome back to another video on APIs in SAP. In this video, we'll try to talk about API lifecycle in SAP API management. We'll briefly talk about what are the different steps in SAP API lifecycle management. Before I begin, I would like to make these videos a bit interactive. So what I will do is, I will ask you three questions beginning of the video, and I will try to provide answers to these questions at the end of the video. So let's begin. Let's look at the first question. What is the first step in API lifecycle management? The second one is, which platform allows developers to search, discover, and subscribe to APIs? The last one, in which part of API lifecycle do you monitor usage analytics, logs, events, and triggers? As I said, if you don't know the answers, it's okay. At the end of the video, you'll find answers to these questions. When you work with APIs, you always have to keep in mind of consumers, who is consuming it, and the provider, who is providing the service. So we have consumers in API management, and we have the providers, which are backend applications. And in the middle, we have the middlemen, which are APIs. I call it as API layer. Let's talk about the backend applications. For example, the backend application can be an application that runs on on-premise, or it can be a cloud application, for example, any SaaS application, or it can be a database server or database service, or it can be any other process. On the consumer side, the consumers can be a mobile application, or it can be a web application, or any desktop application, or any other application like IoT application or any other service. So let's talk about the middle layer. I'll call it as API layer, application programming interface layer. So what is the first step in API lifecycle management? The first step is build. In this step, you try to build the API according to the schema and specifications. You define the request and response messages according to the specification. So once the build is done, you test it. So you use any API test applications like Postman or any SAP UI. So you test the API so that you make sure it is actually working according to the specification. And the third step is publish. So once the API is tested, you publish the API to SAP Business Hub. So this Business Hub application acts as a store for all your APIs. For example, in olden days, we had something called service registry. So Business Hub has the same function to discover and search APIs. And the next step is monetize. For example, if you want to generate revenues out of your API services, you can monetize them. So this is the step where you configure the monetization aspects for your service. So once it is monetized, so the consumers will start consuming your services. For example, once the API is ready and the mobile applications or consumers can consume your APIs, the last step is analyze. You can actually analyze the traffic of your API calls, and you can fine-tune the performance parameters to adjust the demand or the needs. So analyze is the last step in your API lifecycle management. So these are the six steps in API lifecycle management. So what are the six steps we have API lifecycle management? Build, test, publish, monetize, consume, and analyze. So now you learned what are the different steps we have in API lifecycle management. Remember, these steps are not only in SAP world, in any application or anywhere other applications which supports API management usually follow these steps. So now we understood the API lifecycle steps. Let's go back to the questions that we covered. The question number one, the question number two, and the last question. So if you know the answers, comment in the comment section. If you don't know the answer, go back and watch the video again. If you have any comments, let me know in the comment section. I hope you learned something new in this video. If you like the video, consider giving a like, share the video, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much for watching.